Hello everyone. Today we discuss about the excretory system. Excretory system is concerned with excretion. Excretion is responsible for the removal of nitrogenous waste matter from our body. The part which is formed in our kidneys, that means the kidneys are giving out the waste matter which is mainly nitrogenous. Now this nitrogenous waste matter is mainly formed in our liver by the breakdown of our dead RBCs or by the breakdown of our proteins. So urea, uric acid and creatinine, these are the main nitrogenous waste matters which are formed in our liver, and they are given out to our kidneys with the help of our blood vessels, and the kidneys are giving out this with excess of water and other salts in form of urine. So this excretion is the removal of nitrogenous waste matter from the body. We have other parts also. We have the excretory parts, the excretory products. We have carbon dioxide and water, which is formed in the lungs by the respiration, no? Because by the cellular respiration in the cells, it is the lungs are giving out carbon dioxide, and the water vapors which are formed, we are giving out in our sweat also, and we are giving out in our air, the expired air which is given out, that is also having, that is warmer, so that is having some part of water vapors in it. Then we are giving out the nitrogenous waste matter that is formed in our liver, and it is given out by kidneys. And then we talk about the excess of salts. It is some part of that is given out in urine and some part is given out in the sweat also. And then we talk about the water. It is given out in urine as well as in our sweat. And last of all, we have the bile pigments. Bile pigments is mainly bilirubin, which is formed by the breakdown of our dead RBCs. And the RBCs have hemoglobin in them. So this hemoglobin, the breakdown of heme is iron and globin is a protein part. So this combines with the bile and it forms bilirubin and bilirubin, two bile pigments, which is giving a yellow color. So when excess of RBCs are broken down, it gives a yellow tinge to our secretions, that is to the urine as well as to the fecal matter, and it is indication of jaundice. So we say that this excess of bile pigments is also given out in excretion. So the excretory organs, we have the lungs, we have the sweat glands, and we have the kidneys. But kidneys are primary the excretory organs in our body. Now let's see the parts. Now the urinary system we have as a pair of kidneys. Then from the kidneys we have two tubes coming out, that is called as ureter, and they are ending into a sac-like structure as the urinary bladder, and it is opening out to our body with the help of a single tube called as urethra. So these kidneys, we have two kidneys, left and right, and the right kidney is slightly lower than the left one. Yes, and from the center of these kidneys, we have the, from this center depression, we have a, from the notch, we have this tube coming out called as ureter. So kidneys are responsible to form urine. Ureters, these are two in number, and they are transporting the urine from the kidneys to the bladder for storage. So the ureters, when we talk about, they arise from the kidneys, the center part of kidneys, and they are ending into the sac-like structure that is called as the urinary bladder. So they are two in number, and when we talk about the function, their function is to transport the urine from the kidneys to the bladder. Now this bladder is a single sac-like structure which is storing the urine for some time until it is full, and it is opening, it is emptying its content to outside with the help of a single muscular tube at the end called as urethra. So this urethra is opening to outside and it is emptying the contents of bladder under our desire. So we say that the sphincter muscles present at the base of urethra is voluntary in nature. But the sphincter muscles present at the base of ureters, it is not under our control when the urine is going to enter into the bladder. We don't come to know. So we say that the ureters are have two in number, whereas urethra is single. The ureters are transporting the urine from the kidneys to bladder, whereas urethra is transporting the urine from the bladder to outside. So this act of micturation, the act of the emptying urine to outside, it is act of emptying the bladder, is called as diuresis also. It is called as urination also. It is called as micturation also. So this impulse to empty the bladder is given by the brain. Now we say that this, the valve present, the sphincter muscles present at the base of urethra is voluntary. Yes, so it is the voluntary muscles which are under our control. Now we talk about the longitudinal section of kidney. Let's see. Now see the internal diagram of the longitudinal section of kidney. Kidney is having an outer protective membrane called as capsule. So this capsule is made up of epithelial tissue, which is protective in nature. Then we have two parts of kidneys, the outer and the inner. The outer is called as cortex and the inner is called as medulla. Outer cortex is darker in color. So because it is having the dotted appearance, this dotted appearance is some part of the nephron, we will see in the next part. And the internal part is the medulla, which is having this convolutions of finger-like projection. So this finger-like projection is called as papilla. And they are attached to the cortex with the help of thread-like structures called as pyramids. So the ureters, when they enter into the central part of kidney, this part is flattened and it is broad. So this broadened part of the ureters is called as pelvis. Where it enters the kidney is called as hilum. So this hilum is a point where the blood vessels enters and leaves the kidney. And this broader part of the ureters is called as pelvis. So it is thrown into the medulla as finger-like projections, which is called as papilla. And papilla is attached to the cortex with the help of pyramids. Now this is the internal diagram. We have the cortex. Cortex is having the dotted appearance due to some part of the nephron. Then is the medullar region. Medullar region is having finger-like projections of the pyramids and papilla. Then is the hilum, the point where the blood vessels, we can see two blood vessels entering and leaving. The red is the renal artery, which is bringing the nitrogenous waste matter along with the blood. So that is impure blood. Impure means the blood which is full of nitrogenous waste matter. Yes, it is oxygenated. And then is the renal vein, which is carrying out the pure blood, the blood which is free of nitrogenous waste matter but deoxygenated. Yes, and this is the ureters are carrying the urine to the urinary bladder. Clear? So we have the internal structure of the kidney along with this blood supply. We have the renal artery bringing the blood into it and the renal vein carrying out the pure blood. Thank you.